It's the Rooftop Radio Show.
Rooftop Radio.
You are now tuned in to 2 hours of your life that you will never get back.
To the Rooftop.
It's the Rooftop. You will never get these 2 hours back of your life.
Welcome to the Rooftop.
What's that? Our name is Rooftop. Go get it. I say, our name is Rooftop. We get it. I say, our name is Rooftop.
It's
the Rooftop Radio Show.
Welcome to the Rooftop.
This your girl, Honey Davis, and I'm chilling with Vet. This is the Rooftop Radio. We about to get straight into it. In the news today, I seen Lamar Odom is at the hospital, or actually, I don't know if he is at the hospital or whatever. I just know that the nigga was found unresponsive 3-4 days ago at the Love Ranch because he was prostituting. I mean, he was looking for prostitutes. I don't know. Hell, he could have been prostituting himself. And times are getting desperate for him. That is probably why he passed out. But in the sources, what I did take upon reading the information was that he was found unconscious at the Love Ranch, where he had been since Saturday. After being unresponsive for days, he finally woke up recently. I believe it was today or such. He said hi to his estranged wife, Khloe Kardashian. And everyone knows who, if you don't know who Khloe Kardashian is, you're right. And if you don't know who Khloe Kardashian is, for people that do,
you probably don't, because she don't do nothing.
Well, she doesn't do anything. She's a damn idiot. And
she's similar to the women at the ranch he was at.
Right.
That's the women he like, you know.
And so basically, they found him. He woke up. He's next to Khloe. Khloe's there. Khloe also contacted the Love Ranch to tell them in the midst of Odom's.
They wanted to come back?
Well, no. She contacted the Love Ranch to tell the owner of the Love Ranch to only leave, you know, the comments to Khloe. And then the Love Ranch owner told Khloe to go to hell. Which, that's probably where Khloe will be eventually, is in hell.
Yeah.
But at the end of the day, Khloe was right there next to her ex-husband, which woke up and he's seen her there. From there on, he's been texting. His dick. Oh, well, it's up now.
Obviously,
it's obviously up now.
I don't know. He was using Viagra, so it's probably still down.
Well, we don't know, but now news.
I saw that crack he's been using.
Well, yes, and it's so sad to see that someone, you know, that came from sports and such a role model like that is he is a role model because he's a basketball player, and a lot of boys do watch after that. But no, well, he's not going to be anymore. I always knew he was a crackhead by looking at him. I knew it. I could tell a crack in his face. And he has a cracky face.
Tyrone Biggums.
Yeah, so but as we know, Amar, he won 2 NBA championships, and he's just a big player, and it's just sad to just see that happen.
I
probably already found his ring.
That's how he got to the ranch.
Okay. Yeah, you know. But in 2009, Khloe Kardashian and Odom got a divorce. Well, they married. Years later. Okay, so they're not together no more. And basically, she's just there for publicity. Long story short, he couldn't get none. He tried to take some pills, got it up, but he went down. They took him to the hospital. He was down for a while. Khloe came in, get publicity. He wakes up. I believe at the end of the day, all of this is just publicity for Lamar Odom and Khloe because they both are crackies and they have nothing else to do in their life.
Man, that give me right up.
But that is
only 35 years old.
Yes,
horrible.
And so that's one of the topics, you know, that people are looking at. If you want more information about that, of course, go to www.therooftop.com. Click on Blogspot where we have
conspiracy theorists actually went wild with this and said that Khloe was actually sacrificing Lamar Odom to get more fame in the no fame world that she lives in of reality TV.
Which could be true because at the end of the day, Khloe's not shit. I know who Kim is, and everyone knows who Kim is. But Khloe, hey, you need to do a porn. Not with Lamar Odom, but somebody else.
Might want to holler at Ray J.
Maybe you should holler at Ray J. There we go. And as I said, if you want more information, go to www.therooftop.com. Check out the blog spot, people. It definitely has information on there to check it out. And other news, something Donald else Trump. That I was reading about Donald Trump.
That's sad.
You know, he's running for president.
Bad day in America, man.
Well, he's running for president right now. Right now, I'm like, well, one thing that
is it a joke now? Is that not important anymore? Are they just trying to show us that the presidency's chair doesn't matter? Is that what they're doing? Because Kanye West said he was going to run in 4 years. And he said his running mate is going to be Lindsay Lohan.
Whoa, well, we don't want her to run for president.
We don't want her to run.
It's going
to
be no war on drugs here.
No, Lamar's on.
Well, Donald Trump, he's just, you know, well, he recently did some crap with a Mexican lady on stage. I didn't understand that one. But basically, he's, you know, he's going after Jeb Bush, I guess is his name. I guess that's one of the Bushes, another fuck up in the family.
Yeah. He is the fuck up.
I don't know if Donald Trump is going to win this or not. But
it's a distraction for something. I'm trying to figure it out.
Right. Here's some recent comments that Donald Trump made. He blames W.G. Bush for 9/11. Let's go ahead and take a listen to that. Right. Let's see what he has to say with that.
I need to know that you will make us feel safe and you will make us feel proud.
I think I have a bigger heart than all of them. I think I'm much more competent than all of them. When you talk about George Bush, I mean, say what you want, the World Trade Center came down during his time. If you
hold on, you can't blame George Bush for that.
He was president, okay? Don't blame him or don't blame him, but he was president. The World Trade Center came down during his reign.
Help us understand.
So you guys heard that, basically, that Donald Trump is blaming George Bush for 9/11, which is so fucking true. Like, it's like, I don't know, I can't really blame George Bush for it, but at the end of the day, I mean, he was in the school reading. He doesn't know how to read,
right.
So I don't know why he's in the school reading, but hey, he was high off crack, like Lamar owed him at the time, and so we can't blame him for that. It's just, you know, the war on drugs. But at the same time, I do believe, you know, that George Bush is the reason for 9/11 in a certain way, because actually I don't fucking know. I just believe the Iranians just don't like us. They just always fucking been after us. And
I don't know if it was George Bush, but somebody got
to. I don't think Donald Trump should be blaming George Bush for that. I think Donald Trump is just trying to talk stuff because one of the Bushes are running and he's trying to get publicity. That's what he does. He throws Mexican ladies on stage.
He
throws kids on planes and drives them around and flies them around. That's what Donald Trump does. If Donald Trump becomes a president for America, then we're a fucking joke, and that's just the god honest truth of it. We're a freaking joke, and I respect Donald Trump because I respect any hustlers. Just come on now, like, where are we going with this in our lives?
Man.
Okay, you know, I don't understand it.
You remind me of Ross Perot, man. Like, everybody trying to make this a joke, and the presidency I thought was an important seat. You know.
Yes. Well, that's some of the news that's going on today. And like I said, if you want to check out more stories on Donald Trump, we definitely have the information, www.therooftop.com. Right now, we're going to go ahead and get into this number 10 gem right here, because y'all know we got the mixes down for y'all. Now, this is Nas. Nas has been bringing this since the 90s. If you early birds are on it, 2000 babies, y'all need to get on this. Nas has been bringing
it
since the 90s. He's definitely been bringing this. So we're going to go ahead and get to the number 10 jam, Nas. UBR, Unauthorized Biography of Rakim. I don't know why the hell he's rapping about Rakim. That's probably why his career is going down. Rapping about other niggas all the time, nigga. Step that shit up. But let's get into number 10, Nas. Here we go. Rooftop Radio. Honey D, best. Keeping it back on.
Dedication to my children, my child, Destiny Jones. To my niece and nephews, Cherie, Malik, Jabari. The world is yours. Acknowledgements. First off, I want to thank God. And I want to thank everybody for helping me out with this. Couldn't do it without you. Chapter 1. January 28, 1968. Born into this world, William Griffin the Great. Chapter 1, Wine Dance, Long Island. Scientific rhyming invented a new style when he met with Eric Barrier from East Elmhurst. The melody they created was the first. Burst on the scene, 1986, but clap to this. 87 dropped a classic disc. The facts is the track list was like 4. The vocals, the beats, according to Marley Marl. recorded in my hometown, Queensbridge. That's why it's so relative. This biography was unauthorized. I spit it how it was given to Arthur Knives. William changed his name at 16 to Rakim Allah, cause Clarence 13 next had New York on lock. Guards on every block, jams in every park. I remember hearing Curtis Blow saying, it can't get better than this. To Run DMC blew my brains to bits. From leather boots to shell toes to the Stan Smiths to Dapper Dan kicks. First $1 million deal ever in rap. 18th letter did that. From 4th and Broadway to Uni to MCA. We followed the leader to Harlem's Apollo Theater. Supreme rap in the 50 that don't rap. Fort Greene, Queens, Strong Island, Wolfpack. Paid in full posse, hot day was on. And Rye had his first born. With the next line, I'ma be easy. His wisdom's name is Fifi. EPMD put a record out, was dope. Tension spread, and I quote, smack me and I smack you back. Sounded like the answer to the I Ain't No Joke track. For a second, they ain't look good. Little tension buzzing from Wine Dance to Brentwood. Misunderstood, all forgot at 16 when I met Freddie Fox. Toting burners, the whole coast most concerned was how was Rakim's flow made Christians convert with Islamic ways. Let the rhythm hit him was the third LP. A sophisticated mean one. Before similar voices with King's Son, a few others. But sooner or later, the game was Rise Kingdom. At 16, some was watching him, mesmerized, respect not jocking him. Was so amazing. Besides, he came on the stage with lasers in his eyes. Walk with me now. Unauthorized biography of Rakim. Epilogue. Mother was a jazz singer. Nephew to R&B legend Ruth Brown. Discography. Paid in full. Follow the leader. Let the rhythm hit him. Don't sweat the technique. That's the end of the group. Went off a solo. Dropped the R, then the 18th letter, then I think something, the master. Was signed to Aftermath, scheduled to release an album, Oh My God, with Dr. Dre. The album was dismantled because of creative differences. The end. Until the new beginning. Yeah. Next book, KRS-One. Peace.
This your girl, Honey Davis. Now, you know I bring you the dopest ads. This one right here is from Forever 21. Now, I love Forever 21, and they have some good sales going on right now. 50% off sales. Shop now. Go to www.therooftop.com and go ahead and click on ads and you'll see Forever 21. Click on that and go ahead and get your discounts for coming to Rooftop. They have heavy hitter jackets, items that just dropped, looks we love, fall jackets all the way to the boots. Go ahead and pick it up today at rooftop.com. Click on ads, click on Forever 21. Go ahead and get your deal, girls. I know you want to look good this fall. Pick it up. Hey, have you guys heard that new Apple iPhone 6 has just been released? And where can you get it and make a change at the same time? www.therooftopradio.com. Go ahead, pick it up. Click on Community Fundraiser. Every time you purchase the Apple iPhone 6 from Rooftop Radio, proceeds will be donated to an individual or a school of your choosing, which is awesome. All you have to do is go to www.therooftop.com, go to Community Fundraisers, and register today. Make a change in your area and go ahead and get your dope iPhone 6. I know you want that. Rooftop Radio, honey.
It's the Rooftop Radio Show.
Rooftop Radio.
You are now tuned in to 2 hours of your life. That you will never
to
get
the
back.
Rooftop.
It's the Rooftop. You will never get these 2 hours back of your life.
Welcome to the Rooftop.
What's up? Our name is Rooftop. Go get it. I said, our name is Rooftop. We get it.
Get it.
I said, our name is Rooftop.
Go get
it's
it.
It's the Rooftop Radio Show.
show.
Welcome to the Rooftop.